So my name is Giulio Mariotti. I am a postdoc here at the in the IPS department. I am a geobiologist in the sense that I study how biology and geology interact in modern environments and especially in past environments. My background is in physical processes, in oceanography. I really like to understand how sediments move around and then my shape, for example, coastline. Once I moved here to MIT, my interest slightly changed from purely physical processes to coupling between physical processes and biological one. And in particular, microbes growing on the surface of sediments, of biofilms. Here we have small jars in which I put some sediments, and then I grew some microbial mats with some specific biochemical condition. Here we are testing how different availability of nutrients, different degree of motion of the water above the surface influence the composition and the biogeochemical cycle of microbial mats. Now, doing experiments at this scale has the advantage of replicability and the capability of doing a few hundreds, testing a few hundreds condition at the same time. So that's very good to constrain the biochemical effects on microbial mats. So this is my favorite toy. It's a very small wave tank that uses a slightly different wave that you normally find in natural environments or in a large tank used for sedimentary experiments. These use standing waves that generate a specially variable flow field. And you can see that in this tank, the waves here is as strong velocities that are able to move sand and create the usual, the famous wave ripples that you can find, for example, on the beach. And here on the side, the wave is not so strong, so that sediments don't move. So this is my physical setting, which allow me to explore how microbes grow on the surface of sediments depending on the hydrodynamic and the sediment transport. So very, very simply, here you can see that if sediments are moving around constantly, the microbes cannot colonize the sediment. It's just a mechanical limitation. While if the waves are small, or at least the velocity near the bed are small, sediments don't move and microbes can colonize it. Interestingly, you can have an hysteresis such that if the microbes are allowed to colonize this part of sediments without the wave, then once the microbial mass, the microbes are established, and then you turn on the waves, you create a storm, the microbes remain there because they are now stabilizing the sediments. This is a slightly larger tank in which I actually perform a series of experiments. So now this is a very old experiment that I just let go for exploration. So the interesting part is here, where there are ripples formed by a previous strong wave, where now microbial mats can grow. And there is an interesting spatial patterns in which microbes seems to grow differently on the crest of the ripples. And I think it's because the presence of even very small waves influence how the nutrients in the sediments and the water are exchanged and create preferential hotspots of growth where the ripple crests are. So these experiments show that microbial mats can grow in a very heterogeneous way in sedimentary environments. Now this is an advantage, is a piece of knowledge. We can use this knowledge of how heterogeneity is created to interpret rocks in which these heterogeneity is present, has been preserved in the sediments, to infer something about the environments in the past, especially the biochemistry in the past, and also can be used in modern environments where microbes are now growing on the sediments and still doing growing in a heterogeneous way. So we can use this observation, this visual observation, to say something about biochemistry in present environments. For example, whether there are a large amount of nutrients or not.